Hi everybody, it's Mr. Neil. I have some very exciting news today. After almost a week, I'm finally starting to see some sprouts coming out of our basil seeds. I don't know if you can see at home, but there's little bits of green in there, and those are going to turn into basil plants. I'm going to put them back in the window so that they keep growing. Hopefully, we'll be able to see them a little better tomorrow. Today, I have two things planned. First, we're going to read a book, and then we're going to talk about staying safe and healthy. So let's start with the book. Today's book is called The Skunk, and it's called, pardon me, it's by Mac Barnett, and the pictures are by Patrick McDonald. When I left my house, there was a skunk on my doorstep. I kept very still. I did not want to startle him, but the skunk did not seem to be scared. Slowly and carefully, I backed away and started down the street. The skunk started right after me. We walked together for a few blocks. I thought it was funny that a skunk and I could be going in the same direction. But after a mile, I realized I was being followed. When I sped up, the skunk sped up. And when I slowed down, the skunk slowed. I took many wild turns, and so did the skunk. I turned to the skunk and I said, "What do you want?" And the skunk did not answer. The skunk was a skunk. I bought the skunk an apple. I gave him a saucer of milk. I offered him my pocket watch. The skunk did not want any of these things. This was ridiculous. I was wasting my time. I hailed a taxi and I sped off down the avenue. And the skunk took the next cab. Outside the opera house, I hid behind a shrub. The skunk did not see me crouching there. Success. I bounded up the steps and I took my seat. I was relieved to find myself between a lady and a gray old officer. But then, of course, skunks can't buy tickets to the opera. The curtains rose and I smiled. In the middle of the first solo, the skunk came trotting down the aisle. He climbed on the lady's gown and then took a seat on her head. She did not notice. She was wrapped. "Excuse me, madam," I said, "but there seems to be a skunk on your head." "Hush," said the lady. "This is my favorite part. So strange and sad." I had to escape. I excused myself and hurried out a fire exit. The skunk pursued me across the city. He followed me through the sculpture garden and the cemetery, and I could not get away. I ran to the carnival and bought a ticket to the Ferris wheel. The skunk boarded the gondola after mine. We rode around in great circles. He wasn't getting any nearer, but he wasn't getting any farther away. I had to admit that I began to panic. I ran past the wharf and turned down an alley. It was a dead end. The skunk walked toward me. "Go away, skunk," I shouted, but the skunk came closer and closer. I lifted the manhole and climbed down into the sewers. I hurried underneath the streets. Many times I paused to catch my breath, but never for long. I had to go on. When I came up, I was in a different part of the city. I found a new house. I bought new things. And on my first night, when I opened my bedroom door, guess who was waiting there for me? Nobody. I threw myself a party. I cooked a large dinner, and people brought me gifts. After dessert, during the dancing, I thought about the skunk. What was he doing? Was he looking for me? Was he back in his burrow? Was he following someone else? I left my party to find the skunk. He was not in the alley, and he was not at the carnival, and he was not beneath the city. I could not find him anywhere. I searched and I searched. There was the skunk. I trailed him down the sidewalk, careful to remain hidden. I think I am going to keep an eye on him for a while and make sure that he does not follow me again. And that is the end of this story. We're going to take a quick break, and then I'm going to meet you in the kitchen, and I'm going to talk to you guys about staying safe, safe and healthy. Bye-bye for now. Hi, everybody. We're back. It's Mr. Neil, and today we are going to be talking about health and safety. One of the things that we've been doing to be safe recently has been staying inside. Another thing that you might have seen recently is when you go outside, people are wearing masks, and the masks help to keep us safe from germs. And another thing that we can do, which is very important, is washing our hands and making sure that we're doing a good job with it. So today I'm going to show you how I wash my hands. So you start, and you always want to turn on your hot water. That might be a little noisy, so pay attention. And you get your hands wet first, and then you're going to get some soap. And to wash your hands really good, you need to take about 20 seconds. And you can't just wash the fronts of them. You need to wash the back of them. You need to wash in between your fingers. Try to get underneath your fingernails. Move them back and forth. You can count to 20. You could sing a song. One of the best ways that I know how, though, is to make sure that you make lots of big, soapy bubbles. That's how I know that I'm doing a good job washing my hands, is if I make lots of big, soapy bubbles. So after they're good and clean, I'm going to rinse them off under the water. And I like to grab a piece of paper towel and dry them. And then I'm going to use the back of the paper towel to turn off the water. If you don't have paper towel, you can use a clean cloth to dry your hands. And you might be able to use your elbow or the back of your hand to turn off the water. But that's how I keep safe while I'm at home, is by washing my hands, and I hope that you guys can all do the same and that you can practice so that when we go back to school, we all know how to keep our germs to ourselves. That's all I have for today. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
I could have washed all night. I'm still